everybody. Welcome to the start of our trip here. We are setting out on a fine vacation. Emily and myself.
Hello.
We are celebrating our 10-year anniversary by going on our first ever Disney cruise. We are so excited. We've been waiting a long time for this. Give you kind of a background, we've been planning on going on a cruise for about 10 years now. We cruised for our honeymoon, and that's about it. Right now, we're currently traveling down to Key West. Our cruise doesn't start till tomorrow, so we decided to pick up a rental car and go out to Key West. So we're driving out there. We're gonna go ahead and document everything. We're gonna vlog for you, just kind of give you our self-guided tour, more or less, give you an idea of what's up. So for people who have questions about the Disney cruise, for people who have no idea what to expect, and also, we have no kids. Yes, cool. We are going on a Disney cruise without kids.
With us. We're going on an adults-only trip.
Yes, an adults-only trip. This is a very much so gonna be a relaxing vacation with character meet and greet. Both of us got in last night, but we were just too exhausted to start vlogging.
Plus, you want to have some good views.
Yeah, you want to have some good views and all that. So, anyways, it's a beautiful day. It's about 85 degrees. The clouds
are gorgeous.
It's just amazing. Couldn't pick a better time to come. We are so excited, so happy to be here. Yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun. We'll keep you updated. We'll keep coming back, showing you all the cool stuff. Right now, our plans for the Florida Keys are really none. I have two musts. I gotta do Kermits. I've heard from other vloggers and from other people that go to Kermits and get some key lime pie, some actual green spectacular. I'm gonna do that. We're gonna do that. And then also the southernmost tip of the United States. We're gonna go there, take some pictures, take some video, kind of walk around Key West.
See the Key West vibe.
Yeah, check it out.
Yeah.
But yeah, maybe try some local food.
We are going on a 5-day Disney cruise out of Miami on the Disney Magic, and our two ports are Cozumel, Mexico, and Castaway Key, the Disney private island. So that's where we're going.
2 days at sea.
2 days at sea.
First day is pirate night.
Pirates in the Caribbean.
The Caribbean.
And then second day at sea is Marvel. And we get to see not only Captain Marvel, the character, on the cruise, but also the movie before it premieres, which is really awesome.
I'm excited for that one. Yeah, I've been waiting for that one for a long time. I've always liked the Marvel movies that are not your typical superhero movie. That's why I really love Guardians of the Galaxy, Doctor Strange, you know, those kind of movies. I really love those movies because they're not just your typical superhero movie.
So I don't know what event is happening, but there are lots of bikers out.
Yeah.
And they've been out for a while. We've seen them for, I don't know, 10 miles back there?
Yeah.
Just here and there?
Basically,
it's pretty
since
cool.
We started by the Everglades, they've been on and off, but there's a ton of them. So we made it. We made it to Key West. We decided to stop by the most southern point first. So it was a little bit longer than expected, about 3.5 hours in the car on the way down there. So
a little bit of traffic here and there.
I don't know if you have never been down here. Parking, if you want to park close, we saw places that you could park at for like $30. They're like, no, Let's we went and found something a little cheaper.
There's
which
some,
is free. So
midtown parking on the side of the street too, but you have to go to a pay stand to pay for it.
Yeah. So we decided to just come on over and find
some
street parking and take a walk. It's nice outside. It's no more clouds in the sky right now. It's still 85 degrees, but a little humid.
Hot.
But yeah, it's hot.
Hot when you're used to 30s, 40s in the middle of the winter.
Yeah,
but,
yeah, yeah.
But I'll take it.
It's March 2nd today. So yeah, and it's 85 degrees in Key West. Beautiful. Just didn't give our bodies much time to adapt. Yeah. All right, so we made it down to the southernmost point. It's up there. There's a line. I'm sure many of you already know, but there's a line usually to get down here and take your photo in front of this little buoy-looking deal that I've heard ranges anywhere from 15 minutes to an hour, depending on, you know, how long the line is, if there's other ports and crews here. So we're gonna do it just to say we've done it. We're gonna stand in line and take our picture with it. There's a cafe boathouse around the corner. It's just back that way
Southern
a little bit
cafe.
And take a right. Southernmost Cafe is what it's called. Thank you. And there's restrooms there. Just walk in like you have a table. I just went straight back near the bar area and grabbed
street
a restroom.
Street parking,
yep. Street parking, $4 an hour. Not too bad. Especially if you're only here to take a photo and go. So yeah, we're going to wait in line here and we'll take
a
photo.
How long it takes.
Yeah. Yeah, we've
not
already...
Too, not too far.
Yeah. Well, I've been here for about a minute or so now, so shouldn't be too bad. Still in line here and all kinds of eccentric people. He just blew his conch shell. That was funny. All right, so we've been in line for about 10 minutes now, and we're actually pretty close to the front. You can see it now, right next to the ocean side. Yeah, so we just finished with their pictures. It was about 15 minutes, after, you know, standing from the back of the line to being done with the photos. So it was nice. People are behind you to help you take pictures. There's everybody's taking pictures, so everybody seems to be pretty helpful. So now we're just going to walk around a little bit, make our way back to the car, and then head over to Kermits. All right, so we are now parked and going to Kermits. Yeah, we just heard some really good things about this place, so we're gonna give it a shot.
Try out the pie. See what else they have.
Yeah, I don't know, kind of getting maybe a little hungry, so maybe get something after this, maybe some seafood. I love seafood.
Yeah, the smells all over.
Oh yeah.
Amazing. Between barbecue, seafood, burgers, just...
All kinds of just delicious smells.
Corn dog. Smell that?
It smells like corn dogs. Also, it looks like Kermit's pretty close to the cruise terminal, so if you do have a port stop here,
it'd be a good place to visit.
Yeah, it'd be a good place to come and visit if you didn't already know about this place. All right, so we're here at the front of the entrance here. We're gonna go in and check it out, see what they have to offer. Everything's green, so yummy. Oh, and it smells pretty good in here too. Kinds of cool stuff, samples and drinks, sunburn, windburn, yep, like that.
Moisturizer and aloe.
Yeah, looks like this is your scented section over here with candles and all kinds of goodies over here. Drinks at $4 a pop, ouch. They have ice cream here. They have all kinds of goodies. Traditional key lime pie, that's what we're going to be getting. They have a tasting bar over here. Local favorites. They have a limeade station, saltwater taffy. Ooh, they got some, looks like some seasonings. I'd probably be interested in that. Ooh, simple cookies. I'm gonna try a simple cookie.
That's a good key lime cookie.
She is trying the key lime cookie. That's the one I have. I think I have the limeade cookie. That's good. How's your cookie? Excellent. Probably gonna have to buy something here now. Here's the limeade. Good. That's good. Not too sweet. Not strong. It's very good. All right. So we're gonna try the garden area, garden seating. There's a really nice koi pond and a bamboo waterfall out here. Yeah, they got restrooms. I like their door sign. For people who really gotta go, it's right here. Just so you know. Yeah. Look at the beautiful koi pond. Oh my gosh, that is so cool. Looks like they're hungry too. Feed me, feed me. Beautiful waterfall. Just absolutely amazing. Absolutely cool. Beautiful, nice little touch, Kermits, good job. I like that. All right, so we're outside in the garden area. We're gonna give the key lime pie a shot, and we're also going to do the slushie. Okay, she doesn't really like pie.
Good.
Yeah? Initial thoughts?
Not too strong of lime, but good.
Yeah?
Creamy.
Is it like sweet or?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Just
cool.
What I'm excited for.
Oh, yeah. It's hot outside. She's been dying for one of these.
That's good. Much sweeter than the pie. But really good. All right, Robert's going to try the key lime pie.
Yummy.
Coming from someone who does like pie. Good. Different. Different than I've ever had, but
very
good.
Very, very good. The crust at the bottom, like, perfect. Like, it doesn't overpower anything. The lime's not overpowering. I love it. Very good.
And with the whipped cream, how is it?
Oh. That's the real stuff.
I'll have
That's
to try that cream. Then.
Yeah. One more.
Okay. Slushy.
All right. Oh. There's a slushie.
I think it's much sweeter, but good.
Very sweet, yeah. Let me try it again. It's good. It's good, refreshing, since it's so hot outside. I don't know, maybe I might not get it again, but it's
more
it's
my taste than yours?
It's, yeah, probably more your taste, but it's still pretty good. I mean. Now that I've tried it, I don't know if I get
the limeade's really good, and it doesn't have that sweet aftertaste.
So what's your overall thoughts?
Overall thoughts, I love the key lime slushie. I'd get this again and again, not just because it's hot, but it's really good. The pie, coming from not a pie lover, I did like it, but it's even better when you get to the cream on top. But I know that's more Robert's thing. Slushy's more mine, so might not have been his favorite, but I would get the slushy again for sure.
My overall thoughts, I mean, I really like this place. It's really cool. It's got a fun vibe to it. The samples they have out are fantastic. They have peanuts, they have some bread and some oils that you can try dipping in.
Snap cookies,
just a lot of really good things to try. If we had more time, or we're going to save most of our money for the cruise, but we did buy, because we really wanted to try the pie, and the pie is by far my favorite. It is amazing. Nothing overpowering, nothing too sweet, just enough. It was, you know, just so you have an idea, the pie was about $4.50 a slice, and the slushy $1.95 for that cup. It's about a 16-ounce cup. It's pretty good size, so not too bad for $1.95. Especially, you know, for a place you only get to come to, so for some people, once in a lifetime. But yeah, overall, really nice, like it. The like I said, the outdoor setting, fantastic, nice place. It's all in the shade, really nice place to cool down. And yeah, the pie, come and get the pie. All right, so right here's Kermit's right over there, and we're just right across the street, and they have all these really cool, you know, touristy shops. Drinks, food, seafood.
Backpack,
all kinds of
jewelry.
Stuff.
Look, San Francisco, 2,554 miles. Havana, 105.
Art. Looks so fun.
Somewhere beyond the sea, somewhere waiting for me.
And they have, you know, topless mermaids if you want one of those in your house. Well, art. You can justify anything under the name of art, right?
Sailing somewhere beyond the sea, she's there watching for me. If I could fly like birds on high, then straight to her arms I'll go sailing. It's far beyond the stars.
All right, so Emily and I decided to eat at this place right here. It's right next to Kermits. We walked up and down the pier. It was a lot of fun, a lot of touristy shops, a lot of bars, just places seemed like a lot of fun. A lot of boats, a lot of fish right off the dock too. Some massive fish, I'm not sure what they're called. Saw some parrotfish, needlefish, all kinds of really cool fish right off the dock. You just would miss if you weren't looking. But anyways, we're eating at this place called the Fisherman's Cafe. I got the fish sandwich and Emily got the shrimp. So I was wrong. She actually ended up getting the, let me pan down. She got the fish tacos. I think I said shrimp, but we got the fish tacos with the sweet potato fries. Looks like she's already into the sweet potato fries. How is it?
Fries are amazing. They're just temperature hot right now, but really, really good. And the fish smells amazing, but haven't tried it yet. Excited to though. And yours looks huge.
I got the sweet potato fries again, and I also got the fish sandwich. We both got blackened, so you see some seasoning and stuff on there because it's blackened. It looks, yeah, not too spicy. We'll give it a shot.
All right, I absolutely couldn't wait to review this. I tried the sandwich and oh my gosh, amazing. It is the juiciest. The flavor is perfect. The sweet fries are perfect. They put a little salt on there. Just makes it absolutely amazing. But yeah, the blackened fish sandwich, a must do. It's delicious. Definitely highly, highly recommend to get the blackened fish sandwich at the Fisherman's Cafe. All right, Emily, she is in the middle of it, but the blackened fish taco, how is it?
Very good, very juicy. It's dripping all over, but amazing. Love the sauce, it's really good.
Did yours get overpowered with any blackened? Like, mine was fine, but how was yours?
I wouldn't even know it was blackened. I just thought it's just well cooked, it's just good. I can't tell if there's specific or different seasoning. It's just amazing, but it's everywhere.
How do you like your sweet potato fries?
Oh, they're so good. So good. Perfectly salted, amazing.
All right, everybody, we made it back to our Airbnb. What a day. Yeah, what a day. We spent probably a total of 7 hours in the car-ish.
After traveling all day yesterday.
Yeah, potty breaks.
Kind of tired.
Drinks, all that good stuff. It's kind of nice traveling in a car without kids, you know, hey, you don't have to stop as much, but that's okay. The food, everything we did today, I had a lot of fun doing. Although being a 7 hour day in the car, I don't know if I'd just go back, especially if just for an afternoon. I'd go back because there was tons of stuff that we saw.
Lots to do. Over by the dock, there were lots of fishing excursions, dolphin watching.
Yeah.
Lots of restaurants, lots of bars, lots of shopping. So if you had activities you had planned or researched, you could easily fill your day. But just kind of driving down there, yeah, it was nice and fun. So glad we got to go to the Southern Point and try Kermits and eat some really good fish.
Yeah.
But I don't know if I would recommend that long of a drive just for a quick afternoon.
Yeah, yeah. There's an airport down there, so if you have the means to fly, maybe fly in and stay for a couple days, because there's tons to do to fill your time.
Or drive down and
take stay.
A full,
yeah,
day or something.
Yeah, it's a pretty drive. So gorgeous going down there. For us, it was a nice day. Sun was in and out of clouds. Just absolutely gorgeous.
Not too hot, but
no.
When you're used to 30s and 40s and you jump into mid-80s,
yeah,
it felt real warm. But
yeah,
we
were
so
sweating,
nice.
But we kind of expected that. So Kermits was fantastic. The key lime pie, hands down,
the best key lime pie I've ever had. We drove back late afternoon. It took us about the same amount of time to get back.
Saturday.
Yeah, it's a Saturday traffic. Yeah, there's a lot
going
on. Just
a line of people going out the same road. So
if you do go, if you can plan to go on a weekday, I'd probably recommend doing that. Also, we didn't notice any cruises at port. We've heard that when there are cruises at port, that the lines tend to get pretty long. We only waited about 15 minutes for the southernmost point.
We've heard it wasn't bad. 45 minutes to an hour waiting just to take a picture.
Right, and so it wasn't really bad. Yeah, we loved it.
A lot of scooters, Vespas, bikes available to ride around.
There's so much to do there that we just didn't have time to do it all in the afternoon.
We walked.
Yeah, we walked to where we wanted to, what we wanted to see. Very much so, obviously, it's a touristy place. It was a fun day. Come check it out. Tomorrow, we start our cruise.
Over the moon. It's
just going to be...
Long time coming.
10 years ago, we went on a cruise. That time, we did Royal Caribbean. It was on our honeymoon when we got married.
Had a great time. Loved the cruise. Absolutely loved it. To the Bahamas.
Yep. And we're out here on our 10-year anniversary now, so this is going to be 10 years later. We're going to do it again, except this time on Disney Cruise. I promised Emily 10 years ago we'd do a Disney cruise eventually. And finally, I'm sorry it took me so long, but we're going to do it. Yeah. So... 5 nights on the Disney Magic, 2 days at sea, Cozumel, and Castaway Key.
Those are the ports, and for day at sea, first one is Pirates in the Caribbean, and second one is Marvel, day at sea. So we not only get to see the character, but also the movie.
Yeah. We're also going to be participating in the Fish Extender Gift Exchange. We got 9 other people in our cabin doing it. We're the Daisy Group. So if you're following us on our vlog, then you can definitely check it out.
And we were kind of on a last minute group.
Right.
Which
filled up. We were shocked. Yeah. It filled up completely, so that's kind
of
nice.
But we're also part of what's called a pixie dust group. It's got a little bit more lenient guidelines than the Fish Extender Gift Exchange. But it all really just comes down to helping make everyone's cruise a little bit more magical.
Yeah.
It's really fun to get to know these families that are in our group before we even step on the boat. And we've had a lot of interaction on our Facebook group for the cruise. And we're even meeting with a lot of different members of all of the Fish Extender groups. We're taking a picture beforehand right as we get on the cruise, and it's just a lot of fun, and it gives you a moment to step back and celebrate with others while they're on the cruise, or what their experience is, if it's their first time or...
Yeah. We made our own extender, which is pretty cool. We'll show you when we get on the ship. We also made our own gifts, put things together. It's gonna be fun. We'll show you, we'll talk about it more. But I think we're gonna sign off. I think it's bedtime.
2 long days, but tomorrow, day 1 on Disney Magic.
I think we got like a 1 or 1:30 port arrival time.
Yeah.
So, being our first Disney cruise, you know, the anticipation
anxious.
Is we're it's just
anxious.
Too much. We're so excited. I can't say that enough.
That's it.
All right. Well, we'll see you real soon.